I'm Frank. I'm the program director here at SOAR, School of Addiction Recovery. And I actually went through this program close to 3 years ago, back when it was still war. And I've just stuck around, lived the lifestyle, implemented it into my life. You know, now I work here. And I think staying present in our lives and connected to the present moment is, at least for me, one of the important aspects of recovery. Because the whole disease of alcoholism and addiction, it's a thief that steals our lives from us, right? It keeps us engaged in remorse and regret and shame, and it keeps us living in the past or living in the future, when in reality, all we really have is right now. And so recovery for me, a huge part of it is living right now. And it's a process, it's a lifelong process. I'm never gonna fully be present or get to this enlightened stage of being Buddha all the time. But the point is, I've built an awareness around these concepts, around the idea of mindfulness, being present, and I try to put it into my life. One of the main tools I use for staying present is actually meditation, right? And meditation, there's all different types of meditation. You know, you can do walking meditation, you can do meditation while you're listening to music, even while you're working out, you can engage in meditation. For me, it's more of like a silent inner peace and inner reflection. So it looks like what a lot of you would imagine traditional meditation to look like. I try to do it every morning. I'm not perfect. A lot of mornings I skip it, or I tell myself I don't have time, when in reality I could make time for it. But most mornings I do it. And what it looks like is, I'll sit down in a comfortable place with my back upright. It can be cross-legged, it can be in a chair, it can be wherever, hopefully in a pretty quiet place. I do it at parks and stuff sometimes too, where there's noises, and that's fine too, because, you know, being present and meditating is all about being just in the present moment, and that can involve your senses and sights and sounds and smells and feelings. But I'll close my eyes. I'll usually set a timer on my phone. I think the ideal time for me is anywhere from 15 to 20 minutes. I generally do 20 minutes, but if you want to start, you can start with 5 minutes or 10 minutes. I'll close my eyes. I'll start just by breathing deeply. I'll breathe deeply for, I don't know, 30 seconds to a minute. Try to just calm myself, calm my thoughts. And then I'll pick a word. And the word isn't so much as important as what it represents. And the word is supposed to represent my consent to have God's actions, or the divine's actions, working through me and working in me and with me. So it's inviting the divine into my life and into my body, into my mind, into my spirit at the moment. So I'll usually pick a word like love or acceptance or divine or God or whatever it means. Like I said before, the word's not as important as what it represents. And I'm trying to have a stillness within, and I'm trying to invite and consent to the divine's presence within me. So I'll sit there, I'll gently bring that word into focus, and inevitably, life will happen, my brain will happen, then thoughts will happen, right? I'll start thinking about, God, what do I have to do later today? Oh, I gotta get gas, I gotta pay these bills, I have this to-do list for work, I have this thing on the weekend, or I'll think about the past. And when I notice my brain starting to veer off, instead of getting mad or chastising myself, I'll gently veer it back, and I'll gently reintroduce that word into my thoughts. And the more I've done this, the better I am at it, the better I've gotten at it. My mind will usually still drift a couple of times during these periods of meditation, and that's totally okay. But the practice has done so much for me. In that present moment, just that stillness and just that breathing and being with myself is something that I never used to really have in my life, especially in addiction. And I think most of the population probably doesn't get too much of a chance to have that moment in their lives when there's nothing going on except the present moment, right? It not only helps me just during that time, but it helps throughout the day. It has a cumulative effect as well. So as I go about my normal days, I'm more aware of being present and just have more of an inner stillness and an inner calmness because I've been practicing that. And like I said, there's a cumulative effect of it, and it's definitely noticeable in my life. And you know, even when I'm just walking down the street more often, instead of, you know, having my mind racing, thinking about thoughts or actions or the past or the future, I'll just be there walking, right? I'll notice things, I'll notice trees, I'll hear birds, notice cars passing, things like that. And I think the more that we can do that in our lives, the better chance of recovery we have, and the more full and meaningful recovery we have. Because like I was saying before, addiction and alcoholism and drugs, they're thieves that take the present moment away from us and to steal our lives away from us. So I think the more that we can live in the present moment, enjoy gratitude, stillness, and mindfulness, the better off we'll be.